straight up in the air. introduce the first two soloists this evening. First of all, the young man from the University of Miami and featured on tenor saxophone and soprano saxophone and a great composer and arranger. Please welcome Chip McNeil. Chip McNeil. You probably already noticed we have a great drummer on this band, and he's from Nashville, Tennessee, and from North Texas State University. Please welcome Chris Brown. Right now we'd like to do a dedication and dedicate the next tune to the late, great Dizzy Gillespie. And, this is Dizzy's composition, and the arranger is the great Dennis de Blasio. And the Jersey genius, yeah. Okay. Here's our version of A Night in Tunisia.
Yeah. Thank you.
like to introduce you to the soloists right now. First of all, from the University of Nebraska, on alto saxophone, tenor saxophone, and the electronic wind instrument, the iwi, this is Matt Wallace. Matt Wallace! And a great jazz trombonist, and this young man's from Tampa, Florida, and from the University of North Texas. This is Keith Oshiro. And now, right now, we'd like to, and of course, the young gentleman who you have already met on the opening number on tenor saxophone, and just now you've heard him on soprano, once again, Chip McNeil. Chip McNeil. And then, of course, we have a great pianist over here, and he's from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Pittsburgh, and he's also from the University of Miami, a great pianist and keyboard player, Doug Bickle. And then, of course, I'm sure you noticed we have a great bass player. And, and this young man really is from Hollywood, California. From Indiana University, and featured on both upright bass and bass guitar, please welcome Jim Donica. And I'm sure you've noticed that we saved the most important section of the band to last. those are the people that play God's instrument. The young man from the Eastman School of Music in Rochester, New York, a great lead player and soloist. Eastman School of Music, right? Yeah, pretty good. Okay, this is John Owens. Now, this next young gentleman, I think it's very important from a music education point of view that I delve into history a little bit about big bands, particularly big jazz bands. And most people tend to think that the most important and macho and domineering person in any big band, of course, is the leader. And that's not true. And never was, by the way. And then they think, it must be the drummer, you know. That kind of personality to hit things. And, No, it's always the lead trumpet player. And he's always the guy totally in charge of all the other wind instrument players within the band. And they totally respect him. You notice how they move out of the way so you can appreciate him in his entirety, you know. And they are totally subservient, of course, to his every wish. I'm sure that's the same in your band. And okay, and this young man actually is with the, I was about to say, see the British Isles? I was at the Royal Air Force Band, you know. The U.S. Air Force Band. He's their lead and featured trumpet player. And where are you actually stationed?
Anadolu, Texas.
of San Antonio, Texas. Oh yeah, and he's a truly great lead trumpet player, and we're very lucky that he decided to go AWOL for 2 months. Oh yeah. My kind of guy. A great trumpet player, this is Paul Stevens. Okay, right now we'd like to do something from the Footpath Cafe album, and this is a rather special Chip McNeil arrangement. In our old rendezvous and reminisce with you. That's my desire. To meet where gypsies play down in some dim. All right, Mike Gallo, we'd like to do something for you. This came about because of our first tour of Brazil, and it inspired Chip McNeil to write this next arrangement. And the composer is the very famous Brazilian composer, Ari Barroso. And isn't that a great name? Nice to you. Even when you say it, you know, it's like Pavarotti, Barroso, you know, and I don't know, I wasn't very satisfied with Mean and Ferguson, you know. Not much theater in that, you know. And it's Ari Barroso's composition, Chip McNeil's arrangement, and we'd like to show you what we've done to Brazil.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right now, we'd like to do something from the Footpath Cafe album that's actually a hopeful Broadway show and just being put together. And the book, or the title of the show, is The Garden. And this particular tune from the show is an original by myself, and the lyrics are by Rudy Michon and Linda Taylor, and this is Chip McNeil's arrangement, and we use it to showcase the talents and versatility of Matt Wallace here. And the lyrics and the story of the song actually are rather interesting. They have to do with the interpersonal relationships between the male and female Black Widow spiders. It's a love song. Okay, here's Matt Wallace and Poison You Blue. Thank you. Thank you very much. Right now, I'd like to just take a moment to mention that how much we appreciated the hospitality backstage and the wonderful food. And wow, that was heavy duty, wasn't it? Yeah, we appreciate that, yeah. When I got here this evening, I weighed 125 pounds. Okay, and we do thank you very much for all that. And also, one thing I'd like to mention very much is that my favorite form of earthling or humanoid, of course, is anybody who is involved in music education. And all those people that are here, all the music educators and music teachers, and in this case, especially our host band director, Karen Hedy. Real success is my maturity and use of discipline over these younger men here. And yeah, it's just one of those things that a leader must do, you know. And I actually enjoy doing it, you know. And it's at moments like this, I turn around to them and I let them really know where it's at, you know. I say things to them like, hey guys, what do you want to play? You know, inspiring things, leadership and all that, you know. Okay. I guess it's the, we took a vote. And, okay, this is from the Big Bop Nouveau album. And, this is a medley of a few of the things that have been successful. And here's the MF Hit medley.
Thank you. Rocky.
Real big band. The bus leaves at 2 a.m. for Albany, by the way. And we'll explain it to your parents next year. Let you know that this is. Oh yeah, where's your band director? Oh, you're the band. Well, Karen, I want you to think of this as we're the two cornet soloists, and not only are these guys your band, but those guys. They're a lot easier to handle, as I understand it, than these guys, but, okay, why don't you take it off, just give them four beats.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot for coming out, everybody. If you're interested, we have MF t-shirts, cassette.